So what's the deal? I see your man, he ain't show up. I got the thing, let it hang and it blow up.
Before Drakeo the Ruler would be accused by the state of California of murder and face the possibility of a life sentence, only to ultimately be acquitted of all charges and still have to cop to a plea deal to get himself out of prison. Before Drakeo the Ruler would push past his comfort zone and team up with Drake to release Talk to Me, an anti-love love song.
He ain't called me personally, but you know, they told me he wanted me to do some shit over the phone when I was in jail. But I don't know what happened. I ended up getting my privileges taken.
Before Drakeo the Ruler would have over 61,000 followers on Twitter, 465,000 followers on Instagram, and 180,000 subscribers on YouTube at the time of this recording. Drakeo the Ruler is a West Coast rapper who's been called one of the most singular artists to come out of Los Angeles since Snoop Dogg and Kendrick Lamar. Drakeo first earned a boatload of attention for his music that featured a laid-back, easy style, distinct delivery, offbeat cadence, and more coded vernacular than you can shake a stick at. Problem is, in California, there's a law that states if you're a gang member, you can be charged for the crimes other members of your gang committed, even if the only gang Drakeo was ever a member of was his music collective, Stinc Team, who, needless to say, are no gang at all.
Even stuff they might not do, be doing, that they were able to try to charge me for something that I didn't do to say that I benefited from it because I know people who commit crimes.
And yet still, Drakeo was forced to spend nearly 3 years in prison that threatened to cut short his once promising career at its most precarious stage, directly in the middle of his come up. What's cracking, guys? Your boy Marlon Palmer back at it again with a brand new video. This one taking a look at the life of Drakeo the Ruler prior to fame here for you on Before They're Famous. Drakeo is still dealing with the fallout from one of the most controversial legal cases against a rapper in recent memory. Today I'm gonna tell you all about how the past few years have changed his life, while also giving you a taste of how he wound up nearly losing the career he worked so hard to gain in the first place. Be sure to follow me on Instagram at ThatDudeMcFly to let me know what you think, and let's get into the story. Drakeo the Ruler was born Darrell Caldwell on December 1st, 1993 in South Central Los Angeles. He was raised in the 100 section of South Central by his mother, who worked as a preschool teacher, and he was drawn to the world of dance and hip hop as a means to avoid the pitfalls of the street life.
I'm from South Central LA. The hundreds.
He was introduced to rap as a youngster, instantly becoming a huge fan of acts like Hot Boys, Webby, Dipset, and Boozy. But it was a battle rapper who had the biggest impact on his career. He told Billboard, "Who actually influenced me to rap was a battle rapper named Cocky though. He was so smooth and calm while rapping, despite saying some of the craziest stuff. It showed me you didn't have to yell or be loud to get your point across." Having learned a thing or two from his watching his favorite artists in middle school, Drakeo teamed up with his brother Devontae to start their own dance crew that eventually morphed into the rap group called Too Greedy. The same group would later evolve into what's now known as the Stinc Team. After attending Washington High School in Westmont, Drakeo would have a chance encounter with the brother of rapper YG, which eventually led to Drakeo being introduced to DJ Mustard, a relationship that would help launch his career. Together, these two rappers remixed Drakeo's track Mr. Get Dough, and after releasing the video on YouTube, it quickly racked up more than 7 million views. From there, Drakeo began to release a number of mixtapes in quick succession, including his breakout project, I Am Mr. Mosley. In total, he released 4 tapes between 2015 and 17, which is when his life would take a turn for the worse. It all started on the night of December 10, 2016, when Drakeo arrived with a dozen or so friends at a party in South LA. A shooting would eventually break out amongst the guests at this event, and a man named Davion Gregory was tragically killed. After that, rumors began to spread that Drakeo was involved in the attack as his vehicle was seen fleeing from the scene. From that point on, he turned into LAPD's primary suspect. A month later, in January of 2017, police would raid Drakeo's apartment, collecting weapons and arresting him on the spot. He went to prison on a weapons possession charge and was eventually released in November of 2017, after which he quickly returned to making music, earning himself national acclaim as a promising new rapper when the Washington Post called his 2017 album Cold Devil one of the most mesmerizing and intimate rap albums to ever float out of LA. Without a doubt, things were looking up for this talented artist. Problem was, the LAPD were far from done with him. In March of 2018, Drakeo would be taken into custody once again. This time, he was indicted on a wide range of felonies related to the December 2016 incident, including murder, conspiracy murder, criminal gang conspiracy, shooting from a vehicle, illegal possession of a firearm, and a number of attempted murder charges. I didn't even know shooting from a vehicle was like a specific charge. But here's the thing, prosecutors knew that Drakeo hadn't killed Gregory as they had already obtained an audio recording of a 17-year-old alleged gang member confessing to the killing. Problem was, they also had the tape of rapper Kells, a member of Stinc Team, confessing to firing additional shots, and law enforcement was ready to argue that Drakeo's rap crew was a criminal gang that planned on killing beforehand.
And then it's kind of easy for them to do it because it's like, oh, if you've been in jail before, if you hang around people who've been in jail, then it's easy to try to make you like a bad person. Like,
using Google and social media, police found a music video of Drakeo's in which both he and Kells are holding a gun that was said to match the ballistics found at the crime scene. According to authorities, this was more than enough proof that Drakeo was guilty. How? I still personally have no idea. That's like finding sneaker prints at a crime scene and then checking to see if I own the sneakers in a music video. Like, how is that me? Prosecutors argued that Drakeo was at the party to kill a rival rapper, but Gregory ended up dying by mistake. Meanwhile, Drakeo and his own lawyers have argued that this prosecution was manufactured and that the analysis of his music is laughable at best. Drakeo told The Guardian, "The whole point of me starting to rap is I get to rap and talk about these things and not do these things. And what would you rather, me rapping about the stuff that I'm not actually doing or out there doing it? It's not real. Rapping is rhyming and pretending. It's a persona." Beyond a run-in with the cops when Drakeo was 16 and stole from a liquor store prior to this event, no member of Stinc Team had a criminal record to speak of outside of some petty crime charges, which you'd think would be proof that this rap collective is in no way, shape, or form a gang. Even the rapper who Drakeo was accused of planning to take out, named RJ, has since stood up for Drakeo and taken to Twitter to let the record officially state that at no point was Drakeo ever trying to kill him. It was all simply a harmless hip-hop beef. While awaiting his trial, Drakeo would release one of his most heralded rap albums to ever be recorded over a jail cell telephone, with his mixtape Thank You For Using GTL. Not only that, but he continued to tweet from his cell and regularly conducted interviews to get the truth out about what was happening to him. Then, during his trial in July of 2019, Drakeo was acquitted of the murder charges against him, but was still held in prison as the prosecutors refiled the charges of criminal gang conspiracy and shooting from a motor vehicle after the jury was hung on those two accounts. Isn't that like double jeopardy and illegal? Needless to say, Drakeo was rightly pissed and he let the entire world know. After that outburst, Drakeo lost all of his privileges in prison and was slapped with a gag order for good measure, which meant no phone calls, no visits, nothing, as he once more awaited his fate. Eventually, the appeal court would overturn this order, but that didn't stop the authorities from forcing Drakeo to spend a considerable amount of time in solitary. Then in late 2020, there was a sudden turn of events. Prosecutors offered Drakeo an opportunity to reach a plea deal, something that was extremely difficult for him to accept. But by this point, after having lost years of his life, Drakeo simply wanted to be a free man. He told The Ringer, "Oh boy, I did not want to take the plea deal. I still feel like it's a setup. They want me to get into trouble. They feel like this is a win for them. I still had to plead out. They still got the gang enhancement. I still have the same judge, so that means if something happens, she's going to be the one who sentenced me to the 9 years that's hanging over my head." That's right, if Drakeo takes a single step out of line over the next few years, the police will have him once again with renewed interest, and he'll be facing a 9-year sentence regardless of the transgression. Even something as simple as a photo with a friend who happens to have gang ties would put Drakeo in deep trouble. But that hasn't put the fear of God into Drakeo quite like the police probably hoped, because within half an hour of his release, Drakeo is already back in the studio, spending 6 hours recording brand new music from his over 200 pages of lyrics that he wrote while in prison. Within 2 days, he had created his mixtape We Know The Truth and dropped it only weeks after his release. Since then, Drakeo has been besieged by million-dollar label offers and has continued to create new music at a prolific pace, dropping The Truth Hurts in the early part of 2021. We know the truth hurts. I see, there gotta be a trilogy. Just don't expect to see any firearms in Drakeo's music videos anytime soon, which is an indication of how seriously he's taking the second chance. After all, he's not about to spend nearly another half decade in prison for no good reason whatsoever. As for the rest of the story and where his career will ultimately go from here, well, that's a video for another time and another place. After all, this is Before They're Famous. And be sure to let me know what you thought about his story in the comments down below. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at ThatDudeMcFly. Follow us on Instagram at Before They're Famous. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.